A Boy at War by Harry Mazur. Chapter 1. "Drop me off here, Mom," Adam said. They were a couple of blocks from school. "Why? I don't mind driving, Mom." He couldn't control his impatience. This is high school. Bad enough that he was registering late. It was already November and the term was half over. "Here," he said. "Drop me off here." And he hopped out of the car. By the time he got everything straightened out in the office, his first period class had started. The teacher was in the middle of a lesson. Adam stood in front of the class while Mr. Handler interrogated him. "Where are you from, Adam?" "No place," Adam said. He was trying to be accurate, but it came out sounding sullen. "No place? I've never been to no place." "I'm military," he explained. "And where's that? Pearl Harbor? Hickman Field? Or is it Fort Knox?" "America," Adam said stiffly. "The United States of America." He was sorry the minute he said it. It sounded so phony and super patriotic, as if he were going to snap his heels together and salute the American flag standing in the corner of the room. "Ah, America," Mr. Handler said. He fixed Adam with a disapproving eye. "We are all Americans here," he instructed. "And though we in Hawaii are still only a territory of the United States, we are Americans, and we will be a state. Now, answer the question. Your hometown, your place of origin, please." He didn't have a hometown. He'd grown up in the military, and in the military, you moved all the time. There was no one place. They'd lived all over, but no matter where they'd lived, it was always the same. Military. Whatever you thought was a military base, that was his hometown. But it was too complicated to explain. Easier to say, "I'm from Adams Center, New York." Which was not the truth, but not a lie either. His grandfather Pelko had a farm there, and they visited him sometimes. Just before they got their orders to Hawaii, they had been there. "Adams Center, and your name is Adam. Are you pulling my leg?" Mr. Handler said. "Are you trying to be comical?" "No, sir." Adam had his eyes fixed on the empty seat in the back of the room. Mr. Handler went to the blackboard and pulled down a map of the United States. "Show us where Adams Center is, Adam." He couldn't find it on the map. "Or the next biggest town, Waterton, either. It's not there." None of this was making him look too bright. "It's a tiny place," he explained, and pointed to Lake Ontario. "It's next to that." "A tiny place next to a great lake," the teacher said. "How many great lakes are there, class? Who knows their names?" Adam knew, but he was through answering questions. A boy with his head on the desk raised his hand. "Davy," Mr. Handler said. The boy sat up. He had a thatch of thick black hair and a muzzy look like he had just woken up. Japanese or maybe Chinese, Adam thought. Something like that. Maybe Hawaiian. He'd been reading about Hawaii. There were a lot of different kinds of people here. Chinese, Japanese, Filipinos, Portuguese, and they were all mixed up. There were more Japanese, though, than any other group. 5 lakes, Davy said, showing 5 fingers, and reeled off their names as if they were almost too boring to say. Lake Ontario, Lake Erie, Lake Michigan, Lake Huron, Lake Superior. "Sticky brain," someone said. Davy looked around. "At least I have a brain." "Class, quiet. Adam, can you tell us something about Adams Center?" Adam was on his way to the back of the room. "It snows a lot," he said.